We have an alumni right now. How are you merging these two?
No, I took part-time classes. So my classes was just from 5 to 8. So during the day, I'm free to do with my work. Time for school.
Na high school kulikuwaje? Because I'm trying to understand of how you're trying to combine high school, you know, classwork and...
Actually, I started towards the end of Form 4.
Were you really serious?
I was studying, yes, but now I was now trying to, okay, high school is done, you have 1 year, what will you be doing? You just can't be there sleeping, drinking, having fun, you know, find something that you can do that can keep you busy from now till you join campus and stuff. So that's how I identified my path in high school.
So you began simply because an opportunity showed up for you?
No, I loved fashion. I loved watching people dressing online, on Instagram, on TV shows. So I could just pick magazines, check the latest styles and trends. So that's when I knew this is something that I want to do after school.
So in high school, precisely you were doing scripts. Then now, once you left, now begin now doing practically the fashion itself.
Yeah. Now, I remember I was in Form 4. I got a call from Daily Nation. They wanted me to go and feature my style. They saw my profile on Instagram. So I had to come to Nairobi during halftime. I did a photo shoot with Kevin Buo here in Nairobi. And then my styles, like six of my styles, were featured on the newspaper. So that was the first time I knew, okay, this is something I can do even after school, you know, just come up with looks, outfits, share it online, you know, show guys this is how you can wear coats on winter, this is how you can wear summer outfit, blah, blah, blah. That's how I did it.
Wow, let's go back now to the fashion business and the industry itself. How would you say that the business is right now?
The business, I can't, it's competitive, yes, because the market, I can't say it's flooded, but you know, fashion is a big cake. So however unique and creative you are, the better for you. No.
What makes you stand out? Because as you said, it's quite competitive. What makes you as Elvis to stand out?
Basically me, like I told you, I'm majoring into men's more than female, because I think it's high time we wake these guys up. I think men are so difficult. You know, it's hard to change a man's wardrobe, but it's easier to change a woman's wardrobe. You know, it's hard for someone to just walk in town with a printed outfit like this. You know, it takes guts and courage. So that's what I said. I want to change this mentality that men have, that they can't, you know, most of them actually, not all of them.
Have you managed to change?
Yeah. Like most of the clients that I'm dealing with right now are male. Someone just like in a week, you dress them for events, for office looks, for anything, because they want, you just create a board on Pinterest and you say, okay, Alfie, I want you to work this with me. Whenever I need something, just go to the board, pick it, make it for me, deliver it this and this day.
So all right, looking at what you have mentioned, Elvis, you have talked about how you began from once you were in high school, that is Form 4. Then now you left Form 4, you came all the way out.
Yeah.
And now you're dealing with man.
Yeah.
What gap had you seen before you even left high school? There was that gap that you saw, a niche that you wanted to fill.
Yeah, I did my research while I was in high school. And I just used to create content about men's fashion, like a blogger. There are a lot of women content creators.
So you began as a blogger?
I started as a blogger at the beginning. So I could just share styles online, you know, take a pic, share it online, show people how to dress, blah, blah, blah. But now when I finished high school, I knew I can turn this into a way I can make money. Yes, I can still create content, but also get money out of it. You know, if I'm talking about African prints today on my Instagram page, I'll post it. But now, instead of, you know, giving a shout out to another person outside there, maybe I can make this pants for someone else and still get money out of it. You know, it's like killing two birds with one stone.
All right, Elvis, let's talk about some of the things that you make as a fashion. What are some of the things that you make for men?
We deal with everything.
Everything.
Yeah, everything.
What is everything?
Customized suit, blazers, Ankara outfits, shirts, casual, anything, depending on what the client wants.
Are men embracing these?
Yeah, they are. So far, so good. I can't complain.
Because, as you said earlier on, men are quite tough. You know,
difficult clients, men clients. You're understanding their style. It's work.
All right. All right. Elvis, I want us to address this issue of borrowing too much from outside. You've seen people like, you know, they take a screenshot, you know, they come and tell, this is exactly what I want. Plagiarism. Do you think Kenya tumefika place, for example, we now want exactly our own people to be creative?
I think people are creative. From what I can see, people, you know, I can bring a screenshot of a design, but it doesn't mean that you have to make exactly that. You know, you can twist the design, change the fabric. If it was Ankara, we can use, you know, cotton or something. Mm-hmm. So that it can't look exactly like that. So I can't really say that's plagiarism. You know, if this thing was on this side, you can say, okay, let's not put it this side. Let's just put somewhere down here, you know, just tweak the design so that it can be unique and not like you borrowed it from somewhere else. Because we need to face the fact, designs are, it's been there since 1700, 1800, now we are 2000, you know, it keeps evolving. So you have to keep up with the pace. Yeah.
Well, as you mentioned earlier, with the rate of competition that is there in the field of fashion and design, how's the demand and the supply rate?
I can't say the demand is high or it's low, because like I said, may just know I know the number of clients I deal with. You know, there's some designers outside here who just depend on one or two people, you know, to satisfy their businesses, grow, and you know, like that's how I work with myself. I just have a group of clients who I know every week I'll make the outfits, you know, and I'll get money to sustain my business, sustain myself, you know, and do all those things.
So for you, don't deal with this. You deal with these particular persons.
Yeah, I deal with specific people. Yeah,
whereby you get to design them and you give them.
Yeah, just them. If it's per week, actually.
Per week.
Yeah.
Like approximation of how many?
Like 3 to 4.
3 to 4.
Yeah.
And your business is this booming.
Yeah, it's booming because now they'll make a huge amount of orders. Not like one trouser. Maybe like I have 10, I need 5 pants, and I need 2 blazers. You know. That's how you do it.
All right, Elvis, there's so much that we can discuss, and the reason to why you ventured into men instead of women is one among them.
Yeah, no, but it doesn't mean that we still dress women, but now our main area, you know, it's just we try to target the men more, but we still have women clients we also deal with.
Oh, so you also work with
them? Yeah, we work with all, but now men is like our main
target. So it's the main and the prime thing.
Yeah.
All right, are you working with anyone so far?
Anyone
in terms of your company, or are you working alone?
No, I have a group of people we work with. I have my friend, she's also a designer. Now she has also majored into female, but now when we have, like, you know, clients from different, you know, we come up and say, hey, baby, you need to help me here, blah blah blah. That's how we work together.
All right, do you do for weddings?
Yeah, we do weddings. All too. Right. Yeah, we get orders for weddings, also do even graduation, funeral.
Graduations, you do gowns or you do dressing?
No, the dressing. For the suit, maybe, and the after party outfits.
How much, presumably, you can just say for a wedding?
No, for a wedding, it depends. You know, if you're dealing with a suit, you have to know the design first and the material that you'll use. But now, suits range from, you know, if it's two-piece suit, the lowest range, 8,000.
Okay.
Yeah, going up.
All right, so it's according to your own will and wish?
According to the design and the fabric that you are using. You know, the different types of fabrics outside there. Yeah, and also the design, you have maybe double breast, single breast, one button, two button, you know.
All those matter?
Yeah, all those matters. You have to include all those factors before you come up with the final price.
Well, what do you need to consider when probably you're launching into the market in terms of the field that is fashion?
Pardon?
What do you need to consider when you're starting a business like fashion and design?
No, first of all, you know, you have to know your target first. Then you have to know which are the fabrics you'll be using, which designs you'll be using. You know, whatever your clients want, it's what you'll work with. It's not what I want. It's what the person wants.
All right.
Yeah.
So it's not about me.
It's not about me. At the end of the day, it's all about customer satisfaction, client satisfaction.
All right. Let's talk about sustaining the business. As you said earlier on, it's quite with a significant amount of people. How are you sustaining yourself in the market?
You know, right now with the rising trends of social media, it's easy to sustain your brand online. You know, just take a picture, share different pictures on Instagram, Facebook, on your social media pages, on your WhatsApp groups with your clients. You know, if there are new fabrics in the market, share it with them. They're like, okay, I need this fabric. I need you to make me this and this and this. And that's how you now sustain yourself.
All right. Yeah. Where can we find you?
On Instagram, Facebook at Elvis Alfie at Alfie Clothing.
Twitter?
Across all social media platforms.
So it's just one name?
Yeah.
Wow. Amazing. And of course, someone commented about your hair.
Oh, thanks so much.
That's a big deal. I don't know whether your Instagram page is ready, so as we can have a look at it. But if it's ready, we'll get to know. When we are talking about fashion, we have quite a number of people who believe, like, we are flooded, that is number one. And number two, we're not as creative as much as we'd want to be. Because people have been seeing images from all over the African continent about, especially Nigeria, has been so much into Ankara designs. Do you think we're doing much?
In terms of coming up with our own designs?
Yes.
Yeah. I think we're just okay.
Are we not the kind of people who borrow too much?
No, uh-huh. we don't borrow the designs. Mm-hmm. I can't say designers borrow designs. No, you know, it's one thing to have a design, and it's one thing to use a different, like I said, different fabric. You know, you just have to treat the design a little bit different. You know? Because if this is what a client wants, you can't tell him, no, you can't do this, and that's what he's brought you to make it for him or her. So,
all right, so this is not just a matter of, like, you know, whatever you want, I can come up with an idea and I give you.
Yeah. Even if the idea, uh-huh. Then on our end, as a uh-huh. team, I will just guide you on how to go about it so that, you know, it can be unique.
All right, so for you, it's about uniqueness.
Uniqueness.
Wow, that's amazing. Mm-hmm. Before we wind up, I'd like you to talk to a few young people who'd like to venture into the business. Mm-hmm. What's another thing that you feel like they really need to address?
You know, at the end of the day, like I said, it's all about your passion. Mm-hmm. Me, I started when I was in Form 3. Right now, I'm, I think, 22 years old or something.
Mm-hmm. And 22 years old?
Yeah. And the reason why I started is, you know, I can't say I wasn't a bright student in school. Mm-hmm. I know sometimes what teachers and our parents tend to believe is that there's this system of school that you just have to follow until, you know, mm-hmm. like right now there's someone who has 200 marks outside there, he's crying, you know, it's like it's from the end of the world. Yeah, from the, you know, it's like I want to be that guy who got 440 marks, but you don't know we are different, you know. Just come up with something, an idea you want to follow and you want to pursue and go for it. At the end of the day, it's what you want, not what.
So for you, in full support of CBC,
yeah,
let's grow talent.
Yeah, let's grow talent, man. Mm-hmm. That's how first world countries are really ahead of us.
Are we in Kenya growing talent as much as you think? You think we are at par?
As per now, uh-huh. Yeah, I think there's that growth, but I think we can do better.
How can we do better in advancing these?
You know, come up with institutions that nurture talents in
like
school.
Like divert.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. If you are into fashion, you know, just do fashion. If you're into music, do music. Don't do chemistry. And you know, it won't help you. Me right now, chemistry is not helping my career at the moment.
Are you sure chemistry is not helping you?
Okay, I don't think those chemical equations are not helping me right now, so.
Okay, yeah. Chemistry to Elvis is not working for him, and it has not been working.
Only English. It's and math. But you have calculators, so.
But of which now, actually, boys actually thrived in this KCP in terms of math and sciences.
And sciences, yeah. Yes. And then the ladies, the languages and Kiswahili.
Do you think there's an issue between these two?
In
terms of performance? Between the boys and the girls?
No, so me, I heard girls are performing better than the boys. I mean, that's what I know.
Comment reserved. Yeah. Anyway, that has been Elvis. Of course, you said where we can find you on Facebook. Of course, get to check out what he has for you. Of course, he's got so much, of course, lined up for you. And of course, keep on checking on his Instagram. That is, he has his Facebook and Twitter, of course. That is what you said.
Yeah.
Many thanks for having me, Elvis. It's always a pleasure to have you.
Thank you so much.
That's it for One in the Morning and, of course, Entrepreneurship Tuesday. Join us again tomorrow in the morning for Queen's Wednesday. My name is Karanjo Alex. See you then. So long. Thanks so very much for coming, man. Paul.
Oh,
yeah, Elikuwa na vanda sote kukupea hiyo.